Who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord, or who shall stand in his holy place?
He that hath clean hands and a pure heart, who hath not lifted up his soul unto vanity, nor sworn deceit.
He shall receive the blessings from the Lord, and the righteousness from the God of his salvation.
This is the generation of them that seek him, that seek thy face, O Jacob.
Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be lifted up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in.
Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle.
Lift up your heads, O ye gates, ye even lift up them, lift up your heads, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. And on together, who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
teaching us. So as we prepare for the word, stand to your feet.
Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not to thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy paths. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And the word of God says in Romans 8, chapter 8, and then verse 30 to 34.
Amen.
Moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. And whom he called, them he also justified. And whom he justified, them he also glorified. And here's the beautiful part.
Yes.
What shall we then say to these things? If God be for us, who can be against
us?
He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for all of us, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifieth. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, rather it is that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. Amen.
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 Power to live right, power not to be succumbed to the flesh, power, you know, to be
able to, even though I see somebody's trying to attract me with something or tempt me with something, I have the power because of the Spirit of God that's in me to not even be tempted. Now the devil's gonna keep trying to tempt you. He's gonna throw stuff your way, he's gonna put things in your way. That's what he does. He's doing his job, but the believer in Jesus Christ who lives by the power of Jesus Christ doesn't have to apologize for anything because we know that we are not going to give in to those things.
All right.
The power that we have. But then what it made me think of is as I was reading this portion of the scripture, it brought me to this point. And the title of this first point that I want to make is God has chosen you.
All right.
That somebody should have been excited right
now.
I y'all did. So let me say this again. God has chosen
Amen.
The reason that that's important and the reason that I'm trying to emphasize that is because none of what I'm getting ready to say will make any sense if you don't understand God has chosen you.
Come on, amen.
If you don't realize that through all the things that God has done, God has chosen you.
The author of the universe, the author of creation
has chosen you. He took time to create you.
Yeah.
He knew what he was doing when he created you. With all of your defects and my defects, God has chosen you.
Amen.
He took time. He looked out and he said, I will make man in my image. And therefore, you and I are created in the image of God. God has chosen
Amen.
God has chosen you. Look at verse 30. Moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. And whom he called, them he also justified. And whom he justified, them he glorified. What all that means, all that predestinate and all that justified, what that means is God looked out over the expanse of time. And in the expanse of time, God said, Willie Doss.
Come on, amen, amen.
2019.
Amen.
I have a mission for you. And he would have said the same thing about Minister Brian Rogers or Evangelist Smiley or musician Darren Gaddy. He would have looked out over the expanse and you and I are not in this place right now because God had not ordained it. God had ordained it, and that is why we are here. So the word of God is for you today to see what you're going to do with it while you go.
Amen.
God has chosen you.
Amen.
That means that us, that God has chosen those who follow his spirit. We are the ones who determine to live a life that God has purposed for us. I'm not interested in living a life of carnality or living a life of sin. I don't want to live a life that's lazy. I want to live a life that God has called me to live. And that is to know his word, to live according to his spirit. And if I do that, God has promised blessings moreover for me. Now for those who get blessed in the midst of it, you ain't doing any of that, you know you ain't living right, you know you're not walking right, then just think about it. If you know you're not doing right now, and God has allowed you to make it to this point, what it is that God really has for you if you live according to his word.
All right.
You get blessed and you ain't doing right now. But God says, I got something that I have predestinated. I mean, that word predestinate is important because it just means that God has predetermined those who would already be with him. But you and I have some responsibility in that predetermination because I have to say that I'm going to live my life according to the word of God. I'm going to give my life to Jesus Christ. And when I do, I'm going to choose to live for Christ.
Amen.
So anybody who is chosen to live for Christ is now being predestined to live with God.
Amen.
Y'all, I don't understand.
Amen.
I don't get it. So God has chosen you.
Yes, yes.
I'm trying to figure this thing out because just the fact that God chose me.
Yeah, amen.
He said God has chosen me. Just because God has chosen you means that you now have the opportunity to the stuff, yeah. Live the way that we want to live, and yeah. Walk the way that we want to walk, and do the stuff that I don't feel like. Somebody made me mad, so I need to cuss them out.
Yeah.
Y'all don't know nothing about that.
Say it, Pastor, say it.
Right? And you're living by the flesh, but when you're living by the Holy Spirit, your words are seasoned.
Yeah, yeah, amen. Yes, yes.
I'm trying to tell you, I was there. I mean, I could cuss somebody out like nobody's business, and people don't know it now because usually I'm sort of like, okay,
yeah.
All right. Yeah. Now, in my mind's eye, what's going on in my head is, okay, Holy Spirit, I need your power, because I really know what I want to say and what I can't say, because I know that if I say what I am going to say, it's not going to bring glory to God. It's going to make me look like a fool before God, and I don't want to look like a fool before God. So guide my tongue,
yes,
guide my attitude,
yes.
Guide my way of walk.
Yes.
And what I've learned is, the more that I'm willing to do that, the more God helps me with how I walk.
Yeah,
he helps me with how I talk. He helps me to do the thing that is right, even when it looks like the easier way is to do the thing that is not right.
Say it, say it.
So you see somebody's money laying over there, and their purse is open, and you see it. The tempter is saying you should just go ahead and go get some of that money. That's the enemy talking.
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Mr. Robert said earlier, just because he's the tempter, which he is not the one who causes you to do it.
Yes, yes.
It is how we walk that causes us
come
to sin.
Come on, man, say it.
But now, not only has God chosen us, right? He has chosen you.
Amen.
But then the second point I want you to see is, living by the power of God's Spirit makes us blameless.
Amen.
Y'all don't hear me. Let me take you to the word real quick, and I'm going to show you. He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for who? I can't hear you. Us. All. Us all. How shall he not with him also freely give us what? All things. Then he says, who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is what he said. You understand what that means? What that really means is, who's going to accuse you of anything? Who's going to be the one that's going to say, Willie Goss 5 years ago was doing this, this, and this, and this. And so he still is in trouble with God. But what I learned is that when I walked with God, when I shared all the stuff that I used to do that was not of God, I don't care who says what to me anymore. You cannot accuse me of anything, because now God said I already took care of that with him. I had a little bit of God here. I might be able to tell you something. That when you was walking in your sin and you finally said, I'm going to stop doing what I'm doing because I love God too much, I can't walk in my sin anymore, then you found out that God, through Jesus Christ, forgave all your sin. His blood washed away all of your sin. His blood took care of all of the work that you need to do. But the charge is that people will tell you what you used to do. People will remember how you used to be. But what you want to be able to show them is that, yeah, honey, you are absolutely right. That used to be where I was. That used to be what I did. But thank God I don't do it anymore. And God, because of his power, I have to follow you again. So he says in verse 34, then he says, who is he that cometh? I mean, condemning. It is Christ that died. Yeah,
yes,
you understand what he's saying?
Yes.
He had out this idea. He's saying to us, you know what? Whoever's trying to charge you with anything, if you believe in walking with Jesus Christ and you live by the power of his Spirit, you ain't got to worry about nothing. Jesus already paid the price for you. Taking away all of your sins through his son, Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
sin again. He gave us now the power of the Spirit to be able to not do it again. It's us who go back. We're the ones who decide we want to go back. We're the ones who decide we want to stay lazy. We're the ones who decide I'm going back to the drugs. We're the ones who decide I'm going back to drinking. And we're the ones who decide I'm going back to sexing. We're the ones who decide I don't want to go to Bible study. We're the ones who decide I don't get up, need to get up and go to worship. We're the ones, because it's no longer Christ who moves you that way, because God wants you in His presence. He wants you to understand who he is. So Paul is laying this out. He tells us that we are no longer blamed. We don't have any blame. Because Christ has made us blameless. You had messed up, but now God has taken away and washed away all of your sin. You don't have to walk the way you used to walk. You don't have to talk the way you used to talk. You ain't got to cuss nobody out. And you don't want to cuss anybody out. You don't want to do wrong when you believe that Jesus Christ has lived and died and gave his life and rose again for you. You don't want to disappoint God. That's why he said that it is that God is glorified by how we live. That's what he's communicating. And so how you and I walk, how you and I talk, how you and I act, those things will bring glory to God, or they will make God look bad. Y'all can't hear me.
Yeah, hallelujah.
Not Satan.
Not nothing.
All right.
Not your ex-boyfriend, girlfriend.
All right.
Come on.
Not the folks you used to deal drugs with.
All right. Say it.
The people you was laying with, you didn't have no business.
Come on.
Not those folks that you used to do your work with.
All right.
Not any of them.
Yeah.
Not none of them. Nobody, nobody,
church open. Extend the invitation to Jesus Christ. We want you to be one of us. One of the us. We want you to be one of them. So we want you, we extend the invitation to Jesus Christ. And I need all of y'all standing to your feet for this invitation. Everybody ought to be standing. Amen. Invitation to Jesus Christ is going out, and we invite you to come and give your life to Jesus Christ. We don't just talk about it, we believe it. We want to walk it. We believe that God is able. So we extend the invitation to Jesus Christ.
Amen, amen.